Android XR uses the APIs and tools you already know from building adaptive apps. This makes it easy to create magical new experiences and scale them across the growing ecosystem of XR devices. If you're developing for Android, you're already developing for XR. Today, we're announcing Developer Preview 3 of the Android XR SDK. This release brings increased stability and a bunch of new features, getting you ready to build the next wave of XR applications for headsets and glasses. Let's start with XR headsets. This is where we've been working closely with developers like you to refine the APIs and tools you need. We've added new features for building rich 3D scenes, such as spatial animations with soft headlocking and transitions. We've also made it easier than ever to adapt your existing UIs with Material 3 components like dialogues and navigation bars automatically transforming into spatial XR elements. Android XR is designed to also power everything in between headsets and glasses, like XReal's Project Aura. We saw Andrea demo how it blends immersive headset experiences into a lightweight form factor with a 70-degree field of view. We call them wired XR glasses. As these devices come to market, your adaptive apps will adjust their UI thanks to new APIs that allow your app to detect a device's field of view. You can start testing the different fields of view right away using the XR emulator in Android Studio. Now, if you've been waiting for more on AI glasses, well, Sharam revealed it earlier. Today, we're opening development for both AI glasses and display AI glasses. Let me walk you through some of the new updates and libraries in Developer Preview 3 designed specifically for glasses development. Last year, we introduced AR Core for Jetpack XR. Now, we're adding AR Core's geospatial capabilities, so you can use the visual positioning service to provide directions based on orientation. You can also use the geospatial API to build content triggers and location-specific actions in your apps. And with AR Core's motion tracking, you can build dynamic experiences that respond intuitively to user movement, like a simple head tilt. Beyond these AR Core updates, we're also introducing two new libraries specifically designed for AI glasses. First, for UI, there's Jetpack Glimmer, our Compose UI toolkit for AI glasses. Glimmer includes familiar UI components like cards, lists, stacks, and more, so you can quickly build beautiful UIs that are designed for glasses with transparent displays. Second, there's the Jetpack Projected library. This foundational API lets you bring your existing Android mobile app directly to AI glasses. You can easily manage audio configurations and access the glasses camera from your core mobile app. As you might guess, the best experiences on glasses are the ones in which AI can help your users take action. We've been collaborating with the Firebase AI Logic team to make the Gemini Live API work with AI glasses. To help inspire us, let's chat with Amit. He leads the writer product team at Uber, and he's been using these tools to help bring their app to glasses. Amit, come on in.
Hey, Matthew. Thanks for having me. It's great to be here. We're bringing the Uber experience to glasses with Android XR, because at Uber, we're always looking for new ways to help people go where they want and get what they need. There are so many possibilities to do that with display AI glasses. One area we're working on is how glasses might help riders stay heads up for an even easier pickup experience. Imagine you've just landed at the airport. After booking your Uber, you instantly see your trip status and ETA right in your view. This simple notification not only keeps you heads up and aware of your surroundings, but also lets you focus on getting to the pickup location on time. In a complex environment like an airport, we know that finding your pickup location can sometimes be challenging. And there's nothing more annoying than having to put your luggage down and pull out your phone. So we're using wayfinding in glasses to provide simple contextual directions. All right, so you've arrived at the pickup and it's a crowded curb. How do you find your driver? Now, instead of opening the app, the glasses can also show you the license plate number and even help you call the driver if needed. This is just the start, but it shows how we can make your journey even more seamless and intuitive, letting you stay present in the world around you. Back to you, Matthew.
Thank you, Amit. What an amazing use of this glasses tech for writers. Now that the demo has you inspired, let's recap how to get started. First, if you're developing for Android, you're already developing for Android XR. That means that if you're building for large screens, your app works out of the box on XR headsets and wired XR glasses. And if you're building features like rich notifications, they just work on AI glasses. And if you want to build differentiated experiences for all of these devices, you can start using Developer Preview 3 of the Android XR SDK and test your apps out on the XR emulator in Android Studio. Your feedback is crucial as we continue to build this platform together. Head over to developer.android.com to share your feedback and join studies that will improve the Android XR developer experience.